I'm Amy of Amy Nicole Floral, and on today's episode we are going to be talking all about how to prepare your containers to get ready to design in them. So selecting the right vessel is so important to having a successful design. So once you've selected the right container, then you need to decide what your mechanics are going to be. I'm going to go over today just a couple of very simple methods most commonly used in floral design. The very first method, and one of my favorites, is called the grid method. And this is really just simply taking waterproof tape and creating a grid over the top of a vase. Definitely some of the pros of this method are it's inexpensive, it's easy to do, and it works on really just about any vase. The second option is chicken wire. This is also a favorite of mine. This is a floral grade chicken wire, and it's simply just kind of ball it up and crumble it, creating lots of little kind of nooks and crannies for your flowers to be placed in. You can take this chicken wire and just kind of shove it into a lot of different types of vases. You can tape over the top, but you're ready to go and start designing right into this. One of the cons of this is obviously there's a cost to this, and sometimes you have trouble getting a lot of extra stems in there. Pro, obviously, it's inexpensive, it's very easy to use, and it's very quick. The third option is floral foam. Now, in my own business, I'm really trying to move away from using floral foam. There's a little bit of controversy about just the environmental impact that it can have, and there are definitely some chemicals in this, so it's not one of my favorite options, but it's definitely very effective in design. In a future video, I'll definitely talk about how to handle this, how to properly soak it, how to use it in a design, but that's definitely some pros and cons. One of the more popular methods right now that's kind of happening is using floral frogs. But essentially this is just a metal pin frog with these very sharp prongs. You secure it into just about any vase using a floral putty that's specific for this type of work. Once it sets, you're ready and you can design really beautiful, loose, airy designs. The frog can stay in some containers, but you can also remove it if you want to reuse that container over and over. The last method is just simply, I would call an armature. Any type of armature is like a branch, anything that's really going to hold your flowers using a natural material. You can green up your vase, you can use branches down inside the water, and then use it to place your flowers to hold everything together. That's it for today's episode. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like it, subscribe, share it with your fellow flower-loving friends, and hope to see you next time.